Hey guys, what's up? This is your boy, it's Jaro, and we're back with another tutorial, but this is going to be one on how to capture with a Hauppauge 1212 HD PVR and how to render out the clips so you can use them to edit with. So, we're going to first go ahead and open up our capture module, which is ArcSoft Total Media Extreme. You're going to click on Record Video, which is right there, which I think I already have one open. But it's reopening for me, so there we go. We're gonna close this up. As you guys can see, I have on my Xbox behind. Make sure down here you have the PlayStation 3, even though if you might be using an Xbox 360, the reason why is the format that it saves the capture files to is M2TS, and it's a lot better format with way better quality than the MP4 for the Xbox 360, as you can see in the bottom left corner here. So make sure it's on PlayStation 3. Video input is YPRPB, audio input is RCA back, PC audio mode is 5.1 channels. We're going to click on device settings. You'll see brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, sharpness. You can change them to whatever you would please. Those are my settings right there. You can go ahead and copy them if you would like. Make sure that the video is on NTSC_M, and both of these are clicked. We're going to go down to format settings. Wait for it to load up. This right here shows your source resolution. I run in 1280 by 720 at 60 frames per second because I run the 720p. HD, not the 1080, because it saves on space for my computer. The file sizes aren't as big. So we're going to want the quality bitrate to be all the way up at the max at 13.5. So that's going to give you the best quality, but that means that your files are going to be bigger than it would be if you had it all the way down here. But you guys can test if you want and see if there's any difference. I just put it on the max because I want the best. We want to click it on constant bitrate here, boost analog audio level. Your low pass filters are going to be 3 and 3, and make sure that you use the AC3 audio encoder, not the AAC. Click on AC3. If you use this one, it's not going to work in Sony Vegas. So we're going to apply everything, click OK. We're going to do a super quick little capture here. So we're going to come down. Everything's all ready. I'm saving it to a place that I save all of my clips to, which is unconverted clips folder. We're going to click capture. Capture us a quick little few seconds and see what we can do. So bouncing around there. There's my little avatar with my magic cards. Woo! So, I think that should be good. We got about 10 seconds. There's Gears of War 3, 2011 most anticipated game ever. Oh! And we're going to stop the capture right there. So, we'll go ahead and close up out of this because we don't need it no more. Closing, closing. Going to open up the folder. Here's my folder that barely have any games in it anymore, only like commentaries and stuff, as you guys can see. But here's our clip right here, so we'll just drag it out here onto the desktop for you guys. Close that folder. So this is our clip that we just captured. Here's Sony Vegas. As you guys can see, I have many projects saved. I use one project that is what I call my test, and it's just a project that's set up in the specifications I need for the Hauppauge 1212. So it has all the like 720 by 1280 like resolution and all that. So we're gonna go ahead, drag in our clip right here into the project media first. If you guys want, come up over here to file. We're gonna drop down to properties. As you can see, my template is this right here. I know it says 29.970. That's only for the editing purposes. Once I render, it renders in 59.94, which is that right there. So you want everything to look like this, pretty much. But I have it on 29.97 for all like editing, because it just makes the preview screen up over here to the right just play so much more easier. So Field order, you're going to click none progressive. Pixel aspect ratio 1.0 square. Output rotation 0. Width and height. Width needs to be 1280. Height needs to be 720. Stereoscopic 3D mode off. Pixel format 32-bit floating point full range. Compositing gamma, we want it 1.0 linear. Full resolution rendering quality, the best. And motion blur type, you want it on Gaussian. Or however the fuck you say that. So, the deinterlace method, you want interpolate fields. Click adjust source media to better match project or render settings. That is just wherever. And you should always pretty much start all new projects with these settings. And it'll make everything better. Whenever you go to render, this frame rate thing right here isn't going to matter that it only says 29.97 because it's all on the template for whatever your render settings are. Like I said, this is just so I can edit easier. It allows it to not lag and all that. But whenever I want to go and do like color correction or take pictures to do like transitions, and I have to bring it and come up over here and put it to the actual correct like frame rate so I can get a good picture. So we're gonna apply it, click OK, drag our clip down here into the timeline. Here's our clip right here. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. So sexy. There we go. Hoorah! Look at my guy. So here's our clip. Double click on it, make sure that you want to do whatever you want to it. We're not going to do anything to it because we're cool like that. Come up over to file, click on render as, and here is the test of the whole thing of what you guys really like want to know. I know this isn't all the best like tutorial, but I'm doing the best I can. And I'm doing as quickly as I can, so this isn't a 40-minute video. So we're going to save as type Windows Media Video V11, which is way down here, .wmv. That's what I use because it's a small file size and it has great quality. The template right here, custom template for YouTube. We're going to show you guys that. So now we're on audio, include the audio, CBR, Windows Media Audio 9.2, attributes 192 at 48 gigahertz stereo. Gonna come down here to video at the bottom. Mode CBR, format Windows Media Video 9, image, size, high definition, 1280 by 720. This is what makes you guys' like videos high definition or standard definition. Pixel aspect ratio is 1.0, frame rate is 59.94, seconds per keyframe, I put 5, override default compression buffer, 3 seconds, click it, and I just go for the sharpest, so I put it on 90, so looks pretty nice like that. Go down to bitrate, don't really have to worry all too much about it, but if you do, internet LAN 15M down here. Make sure that you change that. So index summary, that's just what you want to put a title on your file or some shit like that. Go down to project, make sure that the video rendering quality is best. Stereoscopic 3D mode, use project settings, and then you're going to make sure that you're going to want to come up here and put a name for your custom template. Mine just says custom WMV for YouTube, and then you save it with the save template. Then whenever you want to go and render your file, make sure to have this render loop region only. So whatever we just marked out here, it's only going to render that part. It's not going to render anything else. Save project markers and media file. I don't really know what that means, but whatever. So everything's all here. We're going to do our file name tutorial, and we're going to save it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little tutorial of mine. I hope Redeyed Pictures that this helps you out, man, and you can actually use your Hauppauge 1212. But if you guys enjoyed this, or if there's any questions or comments that you have, be sure to send me a message or just comment on the video below and I will get back to you guys. If you guys did enjoy it, also be sure to drop me a like and a favorite. So we'll see you next time, guys, for another tutorial. I'll be bringing one out shortly for some more transitions for Battlefield Bad Company 2 or any other game that you would like to use it for. And if you guys have not seen my very first tutorial, be sure to check it out in the annotation above. I'm out of here. I'm your boy, it's Gyro, and have a good one.